I came here, ironically, as a teacher, and I'm leaving a student of Israel, a student who wants to share so many of these stories with the Freedom Riders. I had a lot of hope that each and every story, each and every tear was an opportunity to see the humanity here, specifically the young kids. They were so positive about peace and about possibility and using words that are so aspirational. They want to sit beside each other. They want to learn beside each other. They want to be together. And I think that's a really incredible place for us to start from. It's a complex situation. It's challenging. But with that, all of risks and sacrifices we'll all make, it'd be so much more rewarding. If it was easy, it wouldn't be as richly deserved. So I'm just so hopeful. For me, it's about figuring out a way so I can follow my trusty compass back to this glorious land and this glorious country and meeting more people, hearing more stories, and continuing to be a student. I don't want to leave Israel. This has been the most amazing opportunity of my life, and I think that I have to start by thanking the U.S. State Department for believing in our vision, and the R being the Freedom Riders. We were a group of very disparate folks who came together at a time where we needed healing and we needed hope, not knowing that our classroom would become a home. And to be able to be brought here by the U.S. State Department and to work with the embassy and be in a home. And that home could be a university or a school or a community center. Working with teachers and students and NGOs has been magic.